If you want to make a video game but don't know where to start, this video should help point you in the right direction. Making games is a complicated subject, but let's try and break it down. When the big studios create games, they do so in large teams. Each person has a specific role, whether that be 3D modeling, programming, doing concept art, or sound design. In reality though, most people don't start with a team of professionals, more just a single laptop and some good ideas. That's at least how I got into it. Luckily, over the last few years, there's been a big boom in the indie games industry. Now smaller teams, or even individuals, can make hugely popular games such as Superhot or Undertale, just to name a few. Every video game runs on what is called a game engine. The engine is what tells the components in the computer stuff like how to render graphics or play audio. Games such as Half-Life 2, Counter-Strike, and Portal all run on the Source engine, which is also why they have so many things in common when it comes to physics, graphics quality, and gameplay. Previously, game studios would have to spend a huge amount of work creating an engine from scratch or purchase a pre-existing one from another studio, which was not cheap. But these days, a lot of independent engines have been made with the sole purpose of people using them to build their games on top. This brings us to the first decision an aspiring game developer has to make. What engine should I choose? And the answer is, well, it depends. There are a lot of engines to choose from, and they each have their strengths and weaknesses, but here are some of the most popular ones. If you're interested in making a 2D game and want to start with something not too difficult, I find that GameMaker is pretty easy to pick up. Some examples of games made using GameMaker are Spelunky, Undertale, and Ink. GameMaker is essentially free, however some features do require you to purchase a license. I don't find most of these too important for beginners, but do note that you can only export to Windows using the free version. Unity, however, allows you to build games in both 2D and 3D that can be exported to a variety of platforms. Being currently the biggest player when it comes to indie development, Unity has powered games such as Hearthstone, Superhot, and Kerbal Space Program. Unity is also used by a lot of mobile developers. Unreal Engine is probably the most advanced of the three. It's an amazing engine for more experienced developers who are looking to make 3D games, but I wouldn't recommend it as a starting point. It's known for powering some really heavy games like Unreal Tournament, Gears of War, and Arkham Knight. Now some of you might know that I'm a bit biased here. After all, my entire YouTube channel is built around Unity, but I do believe that Unity is the perfect starting point for most developers. This is not because it does everything perfectly, no engine does, but because of its diversity. Unity supports both 2D and 3D games and deploys to both the web, desktop, mobile, and console. Also, when programming in Unity, you can choose between C# and JavaScript, two widely adopted programming languages. So what you learn in Unity can easily be applied to other environments later down the road. That's why I've decided to make a short series on how you can make your first game in Unity. The videos aim to teach a bit about everything, so that no matter if you want to become an artist, a level designer, or a programmer, you will hopefully find it useful. So click on the screen now to be taken to the first video once it's out, and that's pretty much it for this video. If you liked it, consider subscribing. Also, if you want to see more videos like this one, you can support me over at Patreon, patreon.com/brekkies. Thanks for watching, and I will see you in the next video. Thanks to all of the awesome Patreon supporters who donated in December, and a special thanks to Sultan Al-Sharif, Derek Hemskirk, Faisal Marify, James Calhoun, Robert Bonham, and Jason Latito. If you want to become a patron yourself, you can do so at patreon.com/brekkies.